And yeah, I think Tamara's right. It is easier to control the Chocobo with the D-pad and not the analog stick. That's one of the small pieces of advice I give to people. Because literally, I must have had tens of people, like 40, 50, maybe more, people like ask me directly, like, do you have any advice for the Chocobo racing? And I usually say, not really, because I don't think there's too much you can say. But that's definitely one of the small pieces of advice I do give, like to not use the analog stick. I also believe it's better. I also find it helps to play on mute when racing. That's interesting, actually. Okay, here we go. Another piece of advice I give to people is that, to me at least, it feels like after a certain stage, a lot of this catch a chocobo is just to do with the balloon distribution. There's like an RNG, I assume, for like which balloons appear where. And sometimes you get a favorable one where you can pick up like 7 or 8 balloons very easily without doing anything. And that already gives you a chance to get like near the 0 seconds or to even win the race. And so if you're unlucky and you end up with like not being able to get most of the balloons at the start, then you're already kind of on the back foot and it's already difficult. So yeah, let's see. That's literally the only thing I would change about this. Like, a lot of people obviously they get upset by this game, like, it's, you know, they shit on it, whatever, and some of that's definitely justified. If I was remaking the game and I wanted this to be in there, I think the main thing I would have done is I would have allowed a quick restart, so that, let's say, you begin the race and you start to kind of notice which balloon distributions are good and which are not, you could pretty quickly just be like, okay, this is bad, I want to restart this run. And then you don't have to worry, like, you don't have to waste like 3 minutes on a run. And so I think that's like probably one of the best ways to do it. This was quick, by the way. It'd be funny if I got less than 0 seconds for this one. I think it's close. I think it's probably under 10 seconds. But that was lucky. That's what I mean. I think the balloons were just very favorable there. well, there you go. Okay. Well, yeah, I don't know what to say. I guess you were there to witness it. I guess I do need to start speedrunning now. I need to speedrun the 100% version. Yeah, now, the bad thing is I have to do this one more time, or do I... Wait a minute. If this happens, do I get both at the same time? I don't, right? Because this is, if you do it literally the first time, surely they won't give you the Sun Sigil, right? Holy shit. So last time I did it in 3 tries, now I did it first time. I guess I know something. But I think I have to do it one more time. Let's find out what they're going to give us here. Do I get it? Yes. Sorry for anyone that expected to see the frustration and rage of me trying to get less than 0 seconds. That's ridiculous. Oh my god. I promise you guys, I absolutely promise you guys that I did not do any practice or any like set up for that. It was just completely just luck, I promise you. That's absolutely ridiculous. Wow. Oh man. Shit. Literally never done that before. Even doing it in 3 runs in the P-Birdman live streams was like a big deal for me. It was like a big kind of like bit of luck. It's a fluke. But I guess doing it first time now, maybe there is something to it. But again, I don't know what advice to give, really. Yeah, I think the best way to do it is to do it on a live stream and have a bunch of people cheering you on. Then you probably have a better chance of making it happen. That's my best advice.